Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I will show you how to edit data in the React Pivot Table component. I will also show you the different editing types: normal, dialog, batch, inline, command column, and editing using a pivot chart. I will open my existing application, where I have installed the SyncFusion React Pivot View package. Here, I have already bound JSON data using the data source property. You can refer to my Getting Started video shared in the card above or in the description below to learn more about local JSON data binding. Let me run this application. See here, the pivot table is rendered based on a JSON object. Let's see how to edit data in the pivot table. I will add edit settings and enable the allow editing property. Now, when I click cell 197, its details will be shown in the data grid. Double-click the cell data to modify it. Here I will change the country to India. You can see in the pivot table India is shown in the row axis. To add new data, I will enable the allow adding property. I also enable the allow deleting property to delete existing records. Check the grid. Add and delete buttons in the toolbar are enabled. I click the Add button to enter and save the new record. I select a row and click the Delete button to remove the records. To change the normal editing to dialog, I set the mode property in Edit Settings to dialog. When I double-click the cell data in the data grid, a dialog pops up showing the details of that grid row. Modified data can be saved using the Save button. If I set the Edit Settings mode to Batch, the edited cell will be highlighted, and bulk changes are updated in the data source by clicking the Update button in the toolbar. Next, I will show you how to perform inline editing. For that, add the allow inline editing property and set its value to true. See here, I can perform editing directly in pivot table cell without using any external dialog. And this is applicable when a cell contains single row data. While clicking this cell data, a dialog pops up like normal editing because it has more than one row data. Let me delete a few records, keep one, and update it. When I click this cell data again, inline editing is enabled. I can also have additional columns in the data grid with command buttons to perform CRUD operations. To do this, I will enable the allow command columns property in the edit settings. See here, the Manage Records column contains the command button to perform CRUD operations. Click Delete button to remove the row data. Click Edit button to modify the row data. Finally, I will show you how to edit using a pivot chart. To change the display of the pivot table into a chart, I include Display Option property and set its view to chart. Look here, the pivot table is displayed as a pivot chart with line series. I can also change the chart series by including the chart settings, and in the chart series property, set the type to column. The pivot chart with a column series is now displayed. Double-click any data point in the pivot chart to edit its value. Let me recap what we have seen in this video. I showed you how to enable and use the normal, dialog, batch, inline, command column, and pivot chart editing types. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use all our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.